Hello everyone and welcome back to the Daily Show again. So let's get started. Okay, so for the S&P 500, what you see over here is basically after hitting a potential double top formation and the breakout of this small consolidation part, you see a potential double top formation, but that doesn't mean for you to go short immediately, but rather to say see how price react to it. So if you look in terms of price action wise, you do get some sort of like a gap up and then after that it closes a little bit lower. So there could be a potential for double top, but in order for you to look for a confirmation of a double top, you actually have to wait for it to actually break of equivalent. So I would want it to break below this low in order to say that there's a confirm of a double top formation that has formed. But otherwise, you could generally just retrace, find some support over here, and then continue further upwards instead. So yeah, that's basically it in terms of potential. So if you have entered this trade, I'll still stick to it. The target remains there. And otherwise, you see here is a high, a higher high, low, and a higher low. So you get a bullish market structure, bullish trend, and normal in terms of strength, because you get 50, 200, and 150. All right, let's move on to NASDAQ. In terms of NASDAQ-wise, you will see on the daily chart, the high, a low, and a higher low. So this is a low, this is a higher low. So this, even though it has closed, it could be closing lower today, or it could be closing upward, then this will form even a higher low. But irregardless, what you get here is a lower high and a higher low. So it could potentially be some sort of consolidation over here, whereby you get a consolidating triangle, be it ascending, symmetrical, or even descending. But irregardless of the case, or it could even be just a flat channel. But irregardless, right now it's in a neutral market structure, bullish in terms of daily trend, and strong in terms of the daily trend as well. So I still wouldn't take my remainder of the profit because price very much remains above it, above the 20 exponential moving average. All right, and let's move on to the next one. Okay, so for ASHR, actually has a very sharp decline. So in this kind of scenario, I wouldn't go to enter some sort like to catch the falling knife. In fact, look at the price action, it was a huge gap down. So I would generally wait for some sort of clearer sign. It could literally get back up and goes back again, or it could just consolidate over here. In which case, if it consolidates and this 20 exponential moving average come into play, and then it bounces above with a higher high, that's where I will enter for a long-term investment as well, because I do see potential support coming in here, and it could also be a potential trade setup as well. But now I mentioned, I'm very clear that I would not suggest anyone to trade for ASHR or even KWEB simply because the tendency for it to gap here and there is too much. And because of that, you will have high slippage if you're looking to take your position in terms of trading wise. So I would advise not to take any trades when it comes to ASHR and KWEB. Okay, but otherwise, you look in terms of market structure wise, you get a high, a higher high, a low and a lower low. So you get a neutral market structure first, bullish, and then you still get a strong 50, 150 and 200. All right, so it could be transiting with some sort of like a neutral structure in the meantime. Whereas for the KWEB, you still get a high, a lower high, low and a lower low, a low and a lower low. So you actually transited to a bearish market structure. Bullish in terms of trend, strong. Okay, so yep. Okay, so it'll be interesting to see how price react to that. Let's look at price action. Did it touches it? So yep, it did. So actually it touches it and bounces up. So if it remains, the existing trend remains valid intact, what you could do is upon a break of a higher high above this, which is the high was 65.21. If actually today the stocks which actually went up and it closes above, it starts from above in fact, then I would lean towards the potential of a stronger bounce. But it could just bounce up over here and then after that retraces. So for me, when it comes to a longer term investment, you could enter a smaller position here and then enter your remainder position over at lower points of the when the clear support has been established per se. So that's how I intend to enter the market. So I wouldn't say that there's a best method to enter the market because irregardless of the method you enter, the key thing is that you enter in a very clearly concise plan that you have thought out beforehand. All right, let's move on to Bitcoin. Okay, so I'm on Bitcoin on the daily chart. What you see over here is a high, a lower high, a low and a lower low. So you get a bearish market structure. And it remains bullish. And it's normal in terms of the strength of the trend. So I would say that potentially, now that he has broken this kind of support, if prices remains below here any further, it leans towards further downside. And what I mentioned earlier here, you should have taken already your first level of profit. And now this remainder is just purely for the trailing stop loss. Okay, so let's look at the 4-hour chart. So on the 4-hour chart wise, what you will see here is a high, a lower high, a low, and a higher low. So this is actually in terms of a neutral market structure, bearish in terms of the trend because price is below these 200 simple moving average. And in terms of the strength of the trend, well, it's actually, let me look at this because this could be strong still. But it's basically 9218.56 and 9218.73. But because this candle is yet to close, we have to look at it before that. So before that, this is still higher. So strength right now is normal, but it could revert back to a strong bearish trend if it actually closes, if price doesn't close much above this 9,100, which would lead toward a further potential further downside. And also if price were to close above this point, which is 9132, then it could form a bullish market structure with a higher high and a higher low. Otherwise, I still lean towards the downside and I will continue to trail my stop loss for this. So yeah, force breakout remains valid. So first target hit. So this second target remains valid. So either you take this particular profit if it does hit below within that region and find support, or you could have a trailing stop loss approach, or you can see how price react if it actually does reaches over there. Alternatively, if this thing just retraces upwards strongly, then I will look to close my remainder of the trade as well based on price action. So yeah, that's it for today, and I'll see you guys tomorrow. Take care. Bye-bye.